in Manchester specifically, everybody in this room will just be delighted to have a lot more cranes in the sky. And if you look at those projects that are ongoing, it's a mix of schemes we already knew about, some schemes that have come up for the first time, and also, interesting for me in recent weeks in particular, projects that perhaps were derailed during the downturn are being brought back to life, but perhaps in a slightly different form.
Adam's already talked a little bit about the sorts of things broadly that have happened in Manchester since you were last gathered here for your property launch. Devolution, obviously, has been an important part of that process. It's certainly been a very important part of the time I've had to spend in working through not just what it means in Manchester terms, but Great Manchester terms, and a whole range of very complex conversations which have had to take place with central government and are still continuing with central government. That's one of the other things you learn about devolution, is that the relationships never change. It's just what you talk about that does change a little.
When I was sitting down to write the skeleton of this talk, I found myself thinking, how on earth did I have time to do all the stuff? And truthfully, I'm not entirely sure. You see, whilst I'm predominantly seen as a property person, my commercial experiences seem to have taken me across a ridiculous range of different businesses and way beyond, and introduced me to some extraordinary people. And that I'm here to talk about them today is a testament to the good fortune which seems to have followed me for much of my business life.